Hey guys, Andy Robertson here with CQE Academy, and in today's video I want to answer a very special question that I get all the time, which is how do I maintain my CQE certification? I completely get it, you've passed the exam and now you want to maintain that certification, and today's video is going to be all about that. I'm going to share the 11 different ways or the 11 different activities that you can engage in to help you maintain your certification and recertify as a CQE. All right, let's head over to the computer and get started. All right, let's get into the video. By the way, I just want to repeat this. You worked super hard to become a CQE. Congratulations. I know you worked your butt off. And now we need to stay that way. We want to maintain that certification. And today's video is going to teach you how to do that. So we're going to start by covering the two different ways to recertify. And then we're going to jump into the Recertification Journal. This is the most common path to recertification. So we're going to spend most of our time talking about the journal itself. And then I'm going to cover the 11 specific ways or the 11 specific activities that you can engage in to earn recertification units. And then I want to show you a handful of different examples of different paths you can take to get recertified. And these are really just a collection of those 11 different activities. All right, let's go and get into it. So there's two ways to recertify. The first is to recertify by examination. You can wait the 3 years. By the way, your certification is valid for a 3 year period, starting on the day you pass the exam up until 3 years later. So at the end of that 3 year period, your certification technically expires. And so you can do two things. You can recertify by exam, right? You can sit for the exam again, or you can recertify by collecting recertification credits. You'll also hear me call these recertification units. And these units or these credits are collected in a recertification journal. So what are the specific requirements? For you to recertify using a journal, you have to obtain 18 recertification units within your 3 year certification period. Now, what is a recertification unit and how do you earn them? So RUs or recertification units can be earned through professional activities that increase your knowledge of the CQE body of knowledge or are job enhancing. Now, in terms of the specific costs, right, there's two different ways to recertify. If you're doing it using the journal and you're an ASQ member, the cost to recertify every 3 years is only $90. And if you're not an ASQ member, the cost is $130. In comparison, by the way, if you want to recertify by exam, if you're an ASQ member, that exam costs $348 as compared to the $90. And if you're a non-ASQ member, the exam costs $448 versus the $130 if you just use the journal. So the journal is more cost effective than the exam. And of course, you always save money if you're an ASQ member. Okay, so now let's really dive into this and talk about the 11 different ways to recertify. So the very first way to recertify is in a category called professional development. So some specific examples of this might include attending an ASQ conference, attending a seminar, attending webinars online, or any sort of workshops that you might attend throughout your professional career or within your professional development. All of those activities fall under the realm of professional development. Now, over here on the right-hand column, I've added this thing called maximum recertification units. You need to collect 18 recertification units, and there's a maximum that you can achieve in each particular category. Now, the way that you achieve recertification units in the professional development category is by the length of time spent in those various activities. So, for example, if you attend a 10-hour workshop, you know, through your organization or sponsored by some other organization, that 10 hours is equal to one recertification unit. So you essentially accrue or you receive 0.1 recertification units for every hour you spend in these activities. The next category or the next way to earn a recertification unit is to simply be employed. So you get credit for being either a full-time employee or a part-time employee, and you can receive up to 10.8 recertification units for your employment. Now, in terms of full-time versus part-time, if you're a full-time employee, you earn 3.6 recertification units per year, which over the 3 year certification period would be equal to 10.8 recertification units. If you're part-time, you can earn as many as 5.4 recertification units over a 3 year period
by earning 1.8 recertification units per year. Now, I want to show you this little math down here because a lot of the remainder of the presentation is based around the assumption that you're going to maintain your full-time employment. So if we start with the baseline that we need 18 recertification units and we plan on being employed for the next 3 years, earning us the full 10.8 recertification units, really what we need to achieve or what we need to earn through the remainder of these other activities is 7.2 recertification units. That's our real target for a lot of these other activities. By the way, similar to your application for the CQE exam, your employment has to be within one area of the CQE body of knowledge. That's really the primary requirement to gain recertification units through employment, is that your job description or your activities that you're engaged in have to be within the CQE body of knowledge. All right, the next category here, or a different way that you can earn recertification units, is to be an instructor. So if you teach any topic that is within the CQE body of knowledge, whether it's at a college or a non-college or any sort of company-sponsored teaching, you can earn credits for your role as an instructor. So the course must clearly apply to at least one area of the body of knowledge, and what you earn is 0.15 recertification units per hour of instruction. Okay, so the next category is to be a student. So if you attend a college or some sort of non-college course, or you take some sort of sponsored teaching through your company or some other professional organization, or you engage in some level of home study, you can have that activity apply to your recertification units. Similar to being a teacher, the courses that you're taking have to relate back to the CQE body of knowledge. By the way, these are for educational courses only, and they don't apply to any sort of short duration workshops. So if you attend a one-day workshop or you watch a webinar, all of that stuff applies here in professional development, not necessarily in the student category. Similar to professional development, if you do attend a college class or some sponsored teaching or even a non-college related course, you earn 0.1 recertification units per hour of activity that you spend as a student. Okay, so the next one is attending ASQ meetings. So if you're an ASQ member and you attend their monthly membership meetings or workshops or clinics, you can earn a half of a recertification unit per meeting, up to a maximum of 11 recertification units. This is a great way to earn recertification units because attending the monthly membership meetings doesn't cost any additional money. And then similar to meetings, if you're engaged in the ASQ process and you become an elected official or a leader as part of a ASQ committee, you earn 2 recertification units per year of service, up to a maximum of 8 recertification units. Okay, the other big category, and this is one I always recommend, is other certifications. So if you're a CQE and you want to become a green belt or a black belt or a certified manager of quality, you can go out and get that certification and earn recertification units. So for example, if you get a different ASQ certification, you earn 2 recertification units. If you get a certificate or a certification from a non-ASQ organization, for example, project management's a big one, you actually get recertification units for other non-ASQ certifications. Exam proctoring, so this is another way to get recertification units. Now that the exam is proctored by Prometrics, I think this particular category is less useful than it used to be, but if you do happen to proctor an ASQ exam, you do get credit for doing so. And then multimedia, so this category here is actually very similar to professional development, but it essentially encaptures things like audio or video, things like YouTube or CD-ROMs or DVDs or podcasts. Any multimedia content that relates back to the CQE body of knowledge can be claimed for recertification units. Now, the challenge with multimedia here is that you can only claim a maximum of 3.6 recertification units. And the math, in terms of the amount of time you spend, is identical to professional development. It's 0.025 recertification units for every 15 minutes engaged in study, which means if you were to watch or listen to an hour-long podcast or a YouTube video or some other multimedia source, you would earn 0.1 recertification units per hour of study. The 10th category is publishing. So if you publish articles or books or you present papers or you do things like media reviews of other existing published works, you can earn recertification units for that activity. And then the last one is simply just ASQ membership. So if you became an ASQ member while signing up for the exam, you actually earn recertification units being an ASQ member. And you earn a half, you earn 0.5 recertification units per year. And if you maintain your ASQ membership throughout the 3-year certification cycle, you'll earn 1.5 recertification units. You can see right here. Okay, so now let's talk through some specific examples of pathways that you can take to get recertified. Remember, the goal is to earn 18 recertification units in a 3-year period. So the first way to do it is to simply be a full-time employee and earn the maximum 10.8 recertification units for that activity, and then pair that up with some professional development. Maybe it's webinars or conferences or seminars. You could essentially engage in professional development to earn the remaining 7.2 necessary recertification units. Now, similarly, though, you could take a different path. You could be a full-time employee, right, and get the 10.8. You could also go out and get a different certification. Maybe it's green belt, maybe it's black belt, maybe it's the certified manager of quality. Get a different certification and earn 2 recertification units, and then get the remaining needed 5.2 recertification units doing something like professional development. Another way to go about it is to be that ASQ member. That's another really effective way to get recertification units. So you're a full-time employee, you're an ASQ member, and then you also engage in some professional development to make up the difference. And then you can actually start mixing and matching. So again, you've got your full-time employment here of 10.8. Maybe you maintain your ASQ membership and you engage in a little multimedia. Maybe it's podcasts, maybe it's YouTube videos. And then you have the remaining 2.1 recertification units over here in professional development, which might be things like webinars. And lastly, and this is a good path too, maintain your full-time employment, right, 10.8. Maintain your ASQ membership. Get a green belt certification or some other certification like black belt or the certified manager of quality, and then get the remaining 3.7 recertification units doing something like professional development. Now, in terms of all 5 of these different paths, you'll notice that professional development really captures all of them. You know, within those 11 different categories, you're probably not going to be proctoring exams, chairing ASQ committees, or being a course instructor or a college student. You may not engage in a lot of those. I think the majority of people engage in activities that fall under professional development, which includes conferences, seminars, and most importantly, webinars. I think webinars are a fantastic way to collect recertification units under your professional development. Now, I want to dive deeper into that because to me, right, professional development and multimedia are 2 of the easiest ways to recertify. So I want to go back to this example. Let's assume, you know, you're not an ASQ member, you're not going to get another ASQ certification. You simply just want to be a full-time employee and get 7.2 recertification units under professional development. Let's talk about what that would look like. So remember, under professional development, you can get a maximum of 9 recertification units by doing things like attending conferences, seminars, workshops, and webinars. Now, to help you get these recertification units, what I want to do is I want to start inviting you to webinars that I hold to help you get these recertification units. And if that's something that you're interested in, head over to cqeacademy.com/recertification to sign up and get on an email list. And that way, as I publish new webinars, you get notified and you can attend and you can earn recertification units that way. The other really effective way to earn recertification units is through multimedia. This includes listening to podcasts, DVDs, CD-ROMs. These are less popular nowadays. But things like video through YouTube or ASQ TV, these are great multimedia sources to essentially earn multimedia recertification units. Now remember, in each of these categories, whether it's professional development or multimedia, you earn 0.1 recertification units per hour. So let's say that you need to earn 7.2 recertification units between professional development or multimedia. That means you would have to engage in 72 hours of professional development, whether that's at a conference or a seminar or webinars or podcasts or YouTube videos or ASQ TV, whatever it is, that's essentially how much time it will take over a 3-year period to accrue that many recertification units. Now, to be honest, I know that sounds like a lot, but really what it boils down to over a 3-year period is 2 hours per month. You essentially have to spend 30 minutes a week watching a YouTube video or ASQ TV or listening to a podcast or a webinar. So if you break it down that way, 72 hours doesn't seem like a lot because it's spread out over a 3-year period. So don't let that 72 hours make you feel discouraged. All right, if you want to learn more, there's a fantastic resource. It's obviously an ASQ resource. Head over to asq.org/cert/recertification. I'll put this in the description below. Head over there. They've got a great PDF that outlines a lot more of the details here around recertification. And remember to head over to cqeacademy.com/recertification. I'll put a link in the description below where you can sign up for an email list where I'll notify you when I'm publishing or when I'm scheduling new webinars that you can attend to get those recertification units. That was it. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, hit that like button so other people just like you can find this exact same content. And obviously, if you're ready to collect some multimedia recertification units, hit that subscribe button so that as I publish new videos, you can watch them and that you can claim those videos under your multimedia recertification units. All right, have a great day.